Hello everyone, what's going on with CocoaPods? You might have seen some messages on social media saying that CocoaPod is dying. You might be wondering what's happening, so I figured let's get over it step by step. First, let me talk about what CocoaPod actually is. Because if you've picked up iOS programming in the last couple of years, there's a chance that maybe you've heard the word CocoaPods, but you've never actually used this piece of software. So CocoaPod is a dependency manager, just like the Swift package manager, except that CocoaPod was available much earlier than the Swift package manager. If you were doing iOS between, let's say, 2015 to 2020, I'm sure that you've used CocoaPod at one point or another. And if you had been doing iOS before CocoaPod came out, I'm sure you remember how much of an added nicety this software was, because before CocoaPod, there was basically no real way to handle dependencies at scale. The best you could do would be to add Git submodules, but then when you would need to update your dependencies, it would be very hard to scale that efficiently, especially when you needed to handle transitive dependencies. But of course, ever since the Swift package manager came out, then became available for iOS, and then became the default solution for most projects, it was quite obvious that CocoaPod was on a downward trend, we could say, and it was also very obvious that nothing was going to change that trend. And it seems that the CocoaPod team acknowledged that situation because a few weeks and actually a few months, I started seeing posts on social media about this about like 1 month, 3 weeks ago. But when I looked at the actual notice from the CocoaPod team, I saw it was from end of November. So all that to say, whenever you see some posts on social media going crazy about something, sometimes they're actually picking up a news that is not as new as you might think it is. But bottom line, the team announced that CocoaPod would be going read-only for its trunk. So what does that mean, and what is this CocoaPod trunk? The way CocoaPod worked is that there was a central registry called the trunk where developers could register their pod spec, which is the file that describes their module. So basically, if you wanted to install, let's say, Eric Swift, to stay in what was popular back when CocoaPod was also very popular, you would write in your pod file Eric Swift, and that would be it. You wouldn't need to give a link to the GitHub of Eric Swift. That information would be pulled automatically from the CocoaPod trunk. And so what's going to happen? You can see it written down just here. The CocoaPod team is going to make this trunk read-only. This means that it won't be possible for developers to push updates of their modules, and one of the motivations is that having the trunk read-only will dramatically reduce the amount of maintenance that the team will need to do. And basically, the team is not killing CocoaPod, but they're putting it into retirement, we could say. So now let's have a look at the timeline for this, because as you will see, the timeline might not be as urgent as some social media posts would like you to believe. Because this timeline is quite long. It's going to happen over 2 years. So 2 years is a lot of time. And you can see that the first time that CocoaPod will go into read-only mode as a test will be at the beginning of November 2026. So you definitely have time to prepare if your project still uses CocoaPod. You've got almost 2 full years to prepare. But the idea is that from December 2026, developers will not be able to publish updates or even new packages, new modules to the CocoaPod trunk. So that means, for instance, that if Eric Swift wants to post a new version, they won't be able to do it on CocoaPod. So what does this all mean for you as an iOS developer? What's the impact for you? So the first impact, I would say, is kind of an emotional one, because especially for people like me who started their career at the time when CocoaPod was picking up speed, the end of CocoaPod, it does have this end of an era vibe. It's like, it makes you realize that things have happened, that time has passed, and that we all need to collectively move on to something else, and even the team behind CocoaPod is acknowledging that. So that's for the emotional impact, but what about the technical impact? Does this mean that your project will break? The answer is no, because since CocoaPod trunk will be going into read-only, existing builds should still be able to proceed because nothing will break, just it won't be possible to push new information to the CocoaPod trunk. But that also means that developers won't be able to push new versions, and so you won't be able to easily update your dependencies. I'm saying easily because I believe that it might still be possible to update a dependency using CocoaPod after the read-only switch by setting manually the URL of the GitHub repo for the dependency and the tag that you want to use, but you won't be able to update your dependencies by just typing a single command line. So I think the bottom line is that if you're working on projects that are still using CocoaPod to manage dependencies, this is definitely your sign to migrate to SPM, to the Swift Package Manager. If you need to convince your management of doing this migration, you can definitely share this official announcement from the CocoaPod team. And if you need even more arguments, you might want to mention that once CocoaPod goes read-only, it won't be as easy to install security updates that might fix vulnerabilities in your dependencies. And usually, this kind of argument does a good job of convincing management of doing some technical migration. That's all for this video. I hope that now this situation around CocoaPod maybe going down or not is much clearer for you. Before we end, I want to extend a big thank you to the CocoaPod team because their software was definitely quite instrumental into making the iOS community and the iOS open source ecosystem what it is today. So I think that they deserve this big thank you from us all. And as always, thank you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.